Okay guys, welcome back. So in this video I will talk about what happens when n number of forces are acting on a certain object. Now if I have some object like this, right, this is object, and if I put n number of forces, so F1 will be like this, F2 will be like this, F3 will be like this, and F4 here, and F5 here, right, F6 here, F7 here, F8 like that, and Fn here, right, n number of forces. So what actually happens is that, so the horizontal component of this one, Fx, for n number of forces in this direction is sigma, when I is equal to 1, from 1 to 9, Fn, right? Fn means, now Fn is not equal, so this is not equal to F1 plus F1, F2 plus, we have to take the composite vector as well, so right? So Fn, I, right? So I is in this direction, and J is in this direction, right? Fn I, right? From I is equal to 1 to 10, so F1 times, in the I direction you have to take the composition, F1 cos theta or something, then F2 sin alpha or something like that. So you have to take like that. So what happens is Fxn. So what happens if it, if Yn is that, it's the same. Sigma I equals 1 from I equals 1 to n, Fn j direction. Right? So the j direction is actually the y direction you normally take. So this is actually equal, like the coordinate system like this. Right? So this is equal. Right, this is a normal coordinate system you take, so this is somewhat, maybe somewhat advanced for non-vector followers. So in the x direction or in the I direction, the forces should be equal to Fxn, and in the y direction or the j direction, the forces should be equal to Fny or Fnj. Alright, so what is the resultant? So what is R or what is Fr? Fr is Fxn whole thing squared plus Fyn whole thing squared equals to R squared, right? R squared or Fr squared is equal to Fxn whole thing squared plus Fyn whole thing squared. So now we are talking in this video and the previous videos, previous set of videos about an equilibrium of an object. So in the last videos I told about, in the last video and the video before the last also I talked about, when if an object is under equilibrium, the resultant of those forces should be zero. Otherwise that object will have some acceleration either in horizontal or the vertical direction. So if there is some force in that direction, there will be an acceleration. So if there is an acceleration, and if the object is initially at rest, or even if it is moving at constant velocity, normally we are taking objects at rest, if it is at rest, the equilibrium will be harmed and the object will start to move. So what happens is, to stop all those, we have to make a zero, net acceleration zero. To make net acceleration 0 according to F equals ma, so F net is equal to, mass cannot be 0, mass cannot be, we can take a net mass, so it is the same mass that we are putting, so ma net, right, F equals ma, you can put F net equals ma net. So for an object to be in equilibrium, a net should be 0, right, so this should be 0 means F net should be 0 because m is not 0. Although m is 0 or not, f net should be 0. F net is equal to 0. So f net is what is called fr or r. Fr or r should be equal to 0. Right? So what happens is, if a net is 0, r should be 0. So that is what is important. Right? If a net is 0, r is 0. So a net is 0 means the object is in equilibrium. So if an object is in equilibrium, R is equal to 0. So conversely, if R is 0, an object should be in equilibrium. So for R to be 0, R, you know that R squared equals Fxn squared plus Fy squared for n types of forces. So for R to be 0, now this is a square, right? This is not plus, plus or minus. This is a square, so this is greater than 1. This is greater than 0. This is also greater than 0. any number that is greater than 0 and that number added to, now when two positive numbers, either they are integers or fractions or any mixed numbers or anything, when they are added, this should be positive if these two forces are not 0. If these two forces are not 0, R should be positive. So if R is positive, there is a force. So there is a force. So the only occasion in which R could be 0 is that if these both these forces are 0. If this is 0, this is 0. 0 squared is 0. Again here 0 squared is 0. 0 plus 0 is 0. So R is equal to 0. So if R is equal to 0, from this you know conversely that Anet is equal to 0. Anet is equal to 0 means the object is in equilibrium. So for Anet to be 0 or for object to be in equilibrium, what should happen is that Fxnet should be 0 and Fyn should be 0. So that's a very important derivation. Right? For Anet to be 0 or for the object to be in equilibrium, the horizontal, the total horizontal force of this object should be 0 and the total vertical force or the total net vertical force of this object should be also 0. So in this video I talked about as to how an object can be kept in equilibrium under n types of forces. So what it actually means is that for an object to be in equilibrium under n types of forces, the total force in any direction, total force in the horizontal direction or total force in the vertical direction or total force in an angular direction, all the directions, for all directions from 0 to 360, if you are taking in free space 0 to 360, all the forces in any direction should be 0, not only horizontal or vertical. Even when you are taking, if you are decomposing the forces into some angle, if you say you are decomposing the forces into an angle of 45 degrees, that force should also be 0. If the number of forces is n, so the decomposition into any vertical or horizontal direction should be 0. So if n is equal to, in the first video I talked about, if n is equal to, the horizontal forces or the vertical forces or the angle forces should be 0. So if n is equal to 3, it will be in equilibrium under 3 forces. So for that I talked to you about when 3 forces are under equilibrium, the third force should be equal and opposite to the resultant of the other two forces. So if you are not watch those two videos, I invite watch those videos and come back. And if under n forces, so in under 2 forces and 3 forces also it will be the same, the total net force in n direction should be 0. So for n forces we have derived a common relationship. So for an object to be in equilibrium under any types of forces, 2 types of, 3 types, 4 types, 10,000 types, 20,000, 1 million or 1 trillion, right? Any type, any number of forces, the total net force in any direction should be 0. So that's the concept. And this is the end of the videos on equilibrium. So in the next video, I'll be talking about a new concept. So new concept on, actually there is also an equilibrium, but it is a new concept. It will be actually a new derivation. So thanks for watching this video and see you then.